like we've been tracking each other, Scar.
Fight!
No, no more fighting. Came to tell you, your people are dead, Scar.
Now, we fight. Maybe you die. Maybe I die. Maybe we both die.
Scar, I could shoot you right now.
Fight!
Shot your Scar, I guess I would. Lost a lot of blood. Given time, you'd have bled to death. Here. Go ahead and drink it. Thinking about taking my hair, I got your weapons right here.
No. No more fighting. The Sinjo. It is done.
Where do we stand, Secretary Stanton?
We have the platform to impeach the president. All we need now are the votes.
And if we don't get them?
The war will have been fought for no reason at all. The Confederacy will rise again.
Reconstruction program.
It isn't working. Now, don't get me wrong. Your bureau's doing a fine job. But the president is a stumbling block.
George, what is it? Good to see you out and about.
Thank you, Stanley. This is Mrs. Madeline Maine.
A pleasure to finally meet you.
Thank you, sir. If you two gentlemen will excuse me, George.
What's all the commotion, Stanley?
President Johnson vetoed the Republican Civil Rights Bill. It's denying freedmen equal access to the law and then bleating about states' rights. It's turning back the clock, for God's sake.
Could I speak to you in private?
In my office.
Very impressive, Stanley. You wear your success well.
What brings you here, George?
I was just wondering, what are your plans as far as politics are concerned?
We are organizing our support. We have a perfect platform. In fact, it seems the election in our district is mine for the taking.
I see. Campaigns can get pretty expensive, I understand.
Of course, Isabel and I will be funding a lot of it. Would you like to make a contribution, George?
There's something that puzzles me, Stanley. You have wealth, and now prominence and position, yet your appetite for venality and corruption never seemed to be satisfied.
Damn you, George. Whatever I have, you never thought I deserved it. I may have made mistakes in the past, but you have to give me credit for who I am now. I am making an important contribution here.
Let me tell you why I'm here.
There's a company mining phosphates down on Mount Royal, the main plantation. It's the kind of unjust operation that gives Reconstruction a bad name. This is one of their labor contracts.
It's more than that. This is a bondage contract. Reprehensible.
There is also a company store dealing in script coupons, juggling outrageous prices against the Negroes.
That is intolerable. We did not free those people, only to force them back into servitude. Unfortunately, the Bureau has no jurisdiction over such stores.
The Bureau may be helpless, but you, my brother, are not.
What do you mean?
The mining company is a partnership between Madeline's brother-in-law, Cooper Main, and one Isabel Truscott.
Your wife. Isabel, in my study. Now!
I understand you own a controlling interest in the Mount Royal mine. Is that true, Isabel?
Why, yes, George. What of it? I put it in my maiden name, Stanley. There's no connection to you.
My God, you're unbelievable. Your partnership underwrites a company store that deals in illegal labor contracts while your husband is head of the Freedmen's Bureau. Now, what kind of ruination is that?
Why, I know nothing about the management of the mine or the store, George.
You'll be selling your shares to George.
What? Don't be ridiculous. Nobody knows except him. I'm sure George won't do anything to ruin the precious Hazard family name.
Shut up, Isabel. How dare you jeopardize my position? George will pay you $1 for your 51%.
Your dear brother is cheating you out of a fortune.
Sign it!
Stanley, please. Don't you see? This is the opportunity.
Sign it. Take this with my apology.
I've misjudged you, Stanley. Thank you.
What you've done. You're such a fool for your brother's good opinion. I made you. And now you're throwing it all away.
God, you make me feel dirty. I have hated myself for years for listening to you, for doing what you said. You've done your best to ruin me. But no more, Isabel. Never again. I want you out of this house tonight.
Oh, Stanley. Now, certainly you don't mean that. Think of all the things we've shared together. Think of all the things you'd miss.
Tonight, Isabel! You take whatever you want. I never want to see your face again.
Well, what can I say? It's, nice.
Why, Mrs. Fenway? It's much more than simply nice. But the previous owners imported the furnishings from all over the world.
Yes, I'm sure. However, the furnishings are not to my nor my husband's taste. Though I'm sure that the previous owners were affluent and influential people.
Oh, very.
Would you happen to know who their closest acquaintances were?
Oh, Mrs. Fenway, the cream of Chicago society.
Now, what did you tell me that your name was again?
Eric.
Eric, that's such a lovely name, one of my favorites. Eric, perhaps you could furnish me with a list of those names?
Well, I don't know as that would be ethical.
Oh, it's a pity. You see, my husband and I are poorly acquainted here in Chicago. We just love to entertain, and a list like that would greatly aid us. Why, it could benefit you as well.
Me?
Yes, of course you. After all, you'd be coming to all our soirees. And what better way to get new clientele than through social events? In such a case, I think that my husband and I might consider a total purchase.
Well, I think the list could be arranged.
Yes, I think it could be.
You bought Isabel's shares in the mine?
Oh, yes, I did.
I can't believe it.
So that makes us partners. There's a good future in this for everyone. If you want to work with us, we're happy to have you.
With that woman?
That's enough, Cooper.
George, please. We were hoping, for the sake of the family, to continue this partnership.
What family?
If you'd rather not, I'll buy you out on the spot.
All right, I'll go along with you. But don't forget, I own the land. You make one mistake, I'll throw you out. Do I make myself clear?
Barry, pleasure doing business with you.
Something's gone bad in him. It used to be just his anger toward me, but now...
Feeling powerless can turn a man, I know that. Let's hope he stays sensible. Where's the place they're making the saw blade?
Tackett Smithy.
Are you Tackett? Haven't you delivered that saw blade Mrs. Main ordered some months ago?
Nobody ever come around for it with the right amount of money.
Mr. Tackett, the blade was never ready.
How much is it? $50.
There's your 50. Minus 10% for the delay. Now, I want that saw blade delivered to Mount Royal by nightfall tonight. You understand? Good. Mrs. Main, thanks.
George!
Over here!
I brought you some lunch.
Every mine needs an office.
If you find me a mattress, I'll bunk down here as well.
You're staying?
Of course. Not in your kitchen with two chairs and a raggedy pillow for a bed.
Hello, Mr. Wynum.
This is May.
Scott Wynum is the new mine manager. This is Mr. George Hazard.
Oh. So you're the mine manager, Mr. Wynum?
Yes, sir.
Where are you from?
Charleston, sir. But I rent a room behind Getty's Lamont store.
First thing I want you to do is tear up those illegal labor contracts. How does that sit with you, Mr. Wynum?
You're the boss.
Now tell me, what do you think a fair wage for a miner is?
I think $15 a month.
Well, all right then, we'll go 15. But let's make it 15 and up according to skill.
Those are high wages for niggers.
These are fine men, Mr. Wynum. I never want to hear them called anything but men. If you have an objection to that, you can go back to Charleston.
Yes, sir. I mean, no, sir. I have no objections.
If they want to buy land, establish a fair price and see that they get it. And offer farm tools to them at our cost. Agreed?
Agreed.
All right, then. Now let's go see your landlord, shall we?
Afternoon, gentlemen.
20 Youth Getty.
I'm George Hazard. I'm running the Mont Royal mine now.
Well, yeah, Cooper Maine said as much.
Well, maybe he also told you no more script. But I'm here to redeem what you have at the price agreed.
Well, then let me look. Let me find it here. Oh, Mr. Wyatt, you still gonna be wanting to rent that room?
That is my intention.
Well, no scrip. My profits go down, rent goes up. I'm sorry.
Then the bed linens get washed once a week.
What's the total there, Geddes?
Oh, yeah, well, it's a... $553.
You have a pen, I have a bank draft. Geddes, may I suggest you lower your prices? If you don't, we'll be forced to offer supplies to our workers at cost.
Oh, Mr. High and Mighty.
This says $353.
Shall we count the script together?
I feel like I've been cheated.
Oh, you do? Well, chalk it up to my being Mr. High and Mighty. Pardon me, sir.
Present for me?
For both of us. It's such a fine spring day, I've prepared a picnic.
Oh. I think the mine's gonna work. I like Winer, and the men like working for him.
Jack Quinlan could run the mine from Pennsylvania after all you've done.
Fine, what would I do then?
Whatever you do best.
Throw my weight around? You trying to get rid of me?
No, never. How are the children?
They're fine. They're at school. Safest place for them.
Will you ever forgive yourself, George? Or me?
You? For what?
Well, if you hadn't been so concerned with my life, Constance...
Oh, no. It's not that way at all. Bent was waiting for me. He would have waited forever. He knew what it would do to me. Given the opportunity, he'd destroy both of our families. But I'll get him before he does. I swear I'll get him.
Something woke me.
I had a nightmare about Libby prison. I rarely dream about the war anymore.
What do you dream about?
I dream of you. As you are now.
No. Madeline? Madeline?
This telegram just came. Elkanah Bent in St. Louis has kidnapped August Maine, son to Charles. Whereabouts of Charles Maine, unknown. Investigation proceeds. I've got to go find him.
No, George. Let the Pinkertons, that's what they...
No. Charlie broke me out of Libby prison. I owe him my life. Oh. I've got to go.
How is it that men never learn? You're not going off to find a little boy. You're going off to find that filthy animal and have your vengeance. George, what if you don't come back?
No. If anything should ever happen to me, you'll be well taken care of. The mine, the mill.
Oh, stop
for
it.
For God's sake, don't you understand? I love you so much. Nothing could ever keep me from coming back.
Please don't go.
I'm sorry, I must.
Expensive houses in Chicago.
Oh, really?
That's what they tell me.
Well, who said that?
Well, someone from Santa Fe.
Santa Fe? I have never been.
Excuse me, may I have the pleasure?
Why, yes, thank you. You're very nice.
Why, thank you so much. So do you. The rubies are wondrous.
Thank you.
Sir, may I?
Oh, excuse me.
You look lovely.
Thank you so much, and so do you. Thank you for coming to my little party.
Well, I wouldn't have missed it. I'm looking forward to seeing you. Drink champagne?
Yes, I can also.
Zombie fan, I don't think I can thank you enough. Tonight was wonderful. It was just like the nights that we had in Mount Roar way before the war. And everybody came up to me and told me how they thought this cottage was so beautiful.
It's a great mausoleum. But I'm sure Harry would feel quite comfortable in it. Oh, I know his name. I know the names of all your indiscretions. Unfortunately, I probably always will. And now it will be Forrest Wilkerson. Unless my eyes deceive me tonight.
Wilkerson III is very rich.
And handsome and charming. And...
Fan, you're the one that I love.
I wish you did. I mean, not that it really matters, it's just... Sometimes I wonder what I could have done differently, what more I could have given you.
What you might have given me? That! Mount Royal, the most beautiful and perfect place on earth, that should have belonged to me. How many times do I have to tell you that is what I want? Oh, and I will get it.
Our agents combed St. Louis. Not a trace of him, nor the boy.
Where's Charlie now?
I haven't heard a word for a while. He gave up his position as scout at Fort Hays after Cottonwood Creek. No one's seen him since.
We'll see what you can find out, will you?
Yes, sir.
Your wife is feeling much better. Blames herself for Gus, but...
Willa Parker. George Hazard.
Pleasure, ma'am.
Mr. Smith from the Pinkerton Agency. Willa and Charlie. Well...
It's a pleasure to meet you, General. I've heard a lot about you. Charlie and I once had felt something for each other. Gus is still very special to me. Will you be able to find him?
We're going to do everything we can, Miss Parker.
Maureen and I love that boy as if he were our own, George.
Whatever it takes, Matt. I promise.
General Hazard? It's about Charlie. Good man, but since the war, he's been lost.
War does that to some men.
But there's a good and caring side to him. He's just afraid of it. I know, I tried to unlock it and I failed. But with Gus, he loves Gus. If you don't include him in this, it would destroy him.
I know exactly what you mean.
But he's not the same as you remember him. Don't give up on him.
Don't worry. That'll never happen.
Nice work on that sorrel. My name's George Hazard. I'm a friend of Charlie Maine's. I'm told you know him well. I need to find him.
General Hazard? Heard about you. What you want with him?
His son's been kidnapped. He needs to know.
Who done it?
A man named Ben. You've heard of him?
A little. Cam don't talk much, said when he's been drinking. I could take you to him if I could get some leave.
Think that can be arranged. How far is he?
All the way to Abilene.
Charlie, give me that bottle, son. Come on, let's get you in the tack room so you can sleep, but I'll put your arm around my shoulders. Come on, Charlie, damn it! Stand up! Go! Let's go on, you've been at it this time. Charlie! You're too drunk to be fighting. Now you get in there and get you some sleep. Go on.
Here? Damn it, I need some feed. What the hell am I supposed to do? Just help myself and let you folks whistle on down the wind? I got money here. I'm no thief.
Charlie Maine. God must be looking down on his angel of vengeance.
Wake up!
Hey, Charlie. Charlie, I got your little boy. Wake up! You look like hell. Smell like a dead snake. I know what you need, Maine. You need a bath and a shave. I'm gonna clean you up, Maine. You're gonna be so sorry, Maine. It's not that I got anything against killing a sleeping man, but this is gonna be a lot more fun. And don't you know, Charlie? I just love to have fun. Here I go. You look real good now. Your daddy a little message, Gus.
Man a foot approaching the livery. Must mean you gents are looking to rent something to ride.
Yeah. You come to the right place.
We're looking for Charles Maine.
Yeah, well, you come to the right place for that, too. That if you can sober him up. I sure ain't had much luck at that recently. Come on, he's in the tack room. I never saw a man as better with horses when he's sober. Lately, it's been a real problem.
Good Lord, you get us some coffee.
Stick of dynamite to do better.
Charlie, wake up. Charlie!
Excuse me, Joe.
McGee? George Hatch?
There's big trouble, Charlie. Elkanah Bent. He's got your boy, Gus.
You know where he is?
Not yet.
Beg pardon, gentlemen, but I think we do.
Leaving a nice little trail for your daddy to follow, boy. Of course, it can't be too good or catch up to us too soon. Don't you worry, he'll be along. So you be a good boy. What you looking at? I want your daddy down in Indian territory. You know why? Because I'm gonna turn that territory into an empire. Just for me. My own empire. And I want to inaugurate that empire with a big splash. You know what that splash is going to be? Your daddy. Mr. Charles Maine. Mr. Charles Maine.
We don't serve the likes of him.
I'm sure you do. That's my friend, man.
This gentleman was just about to take our order, weren't you, friend?
Sure, sure. What'll it be?
What do you say, magic? Steak and eggs?
Yeah, and some pancakes.
How about some biscuits?
Yeah, give me some coffee and some biscuits.
Help the coffee? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Three okay. times around.
He's gonna run us a chase, Charlie.
Well, he may read a map, but he doesn't know these parts like I do. You think he's gonna keep Gus alive, Charlie?
Till he sees you. He'll try and kill him right before your eyes just to make you suffer. But we're not gonna let that happen.
15, 20 hours a day and set, are you up for that?
Better finish your breakfast there, Charlie. We've got a long day ahead of us.
George, you said in Pennsylvania, this is some of the toughest country God ever made. I just need to know if you can keep up.
Don't you worry about it. It is not your problem.
Well, for my son's sake, I sure hope so.
Gentlemen, there is a time for talking and there is a time for doing. I figure we done talked more than enough.
You know, he's got a point, Cooper. You said when Hazard left, and he's gone.
I know what I said.
Well, there you are. When are we gonna act?
Soon.
Carlson, what I propose is to do enough damage to Mount Royal so I can buy George Hazard's shares in the mill and the mine cheaply.
So what you're saying is this is not just another ride down to scare a few niggas. You want to run them folks off for good? Well, that's a war. And for a war, you better have some besides men wearing sheets and carrying torches.
Dynamite. You got dynamite, Cooper. You've been demolishing all them ruined docks and such. You got dynamite for that purpose. Them damn Yankees, they won't question a few missing sticks.
Maybe.
Maybe, hell. You're gonna requisition a few more sticks and you're gonna say that some fool overcharged you for demolition. Hell, I do it in my business all the time.
Now, that's right. And if you can't come up with it, I'm sure General Forrest can come up with some.
I've heard an awful lot about Nathan Bedford Forrest, but I don't see him running with us or risking his neck.
He did some fierce fighting during the war.
The war's over.
Black hell it is.
I'll get the dynamite.
Ta. Hey?
Oh, gentlemen, if you'll excuse me.
Ah. Oh. Evening. That's me.
What are those men doing in our home, Cooper?
That's really none of your business, is it?
First few days always the hardest, General. So why don't we take care of these horses later and go get some food?
Good idea, McGee.
You hadn't slowed us down yet. I don't reckon you're going to. Especially seeing how you seem to be. Sit in the saddle might easier every morning.
Really? Hadn't noticed.
Supplies 3 days ago and left.
What about Gus?
There was a boy with him.
What do you got, Charlie?
George, these are stones I gave Gus. Let's go. Boys marking us a trail.
Rocks?
Uh-huh. We might just find our friend Bent before he wants us to.
We'll camp here for the night.
You're gonna go blind to keep staring at that rock.
If I find Gus, George.
When you find him, Charlie.
I tell you, I'm not going to be apart from him again.
What about Willa?
You met Willa?
Sure. Duncan's house in St. Louis. She's a fine woman, Charlie.
Yes, she is. She is.
Charlie, you know, last couple of months, Madeline and I have,
what? It's good, George. It's real good. Of course, I don't know what she sees in you, but that's good.
Yeah. Appreciate the meal, ma'am.
Why do you got the boy bound up so?
He's not quite right in the head. He tends to wander off and get lost. He's been that way ever since his pa was killed up by the Platte River.
He was beat up some.
My nephew's a clumsy child. He's a real danger to himself.
Is that right, boy?
Where's your husband?
Out after Buffalo. He'll be back any minute now.
Must be hard living up here. Fending for yourselves in the middle of Indian territory.
Yeah, well, we used to get a few visits from the Cheyenne. And Frank and me is expert shots. They don't come around no more.
That's good. That's enough. Give me a spoon. Listen, maybe you can help me out. I'm a trade man. I got goods to sell and trade. I'm looking for the best spot.
Glenn's Post. 2 days down to Arkansas, west of the Cimarron. Follow it downstream.
Come on. Be a good boy. You're gonna be seeing your daddy real quick.
I thought you said his pa was dead.
Get up here, boy.
Go on. You just get along now.
Anybody come around here asking for Elkanah Bent? You send him over to Glenn's place. Step up.
Hey,
They've been with us for a few days now. Touched in the head. Might run away and get lost.
He's marked up some.
Fell off a horse. You Glenn? I'm looking for a place to stay for a while. How's that set with you?
50 cents a night for the both of you. Unless you mark the back room, that's another dollar. You want green grass here, it's $2 a whack.
Mind if I take a look around inside? You got a nice place here, Mr. Glenn. But the price is too high. English. Plant them in the ground.
Indian camp, Captain?
Uh-huh. No more than 2 hours dead.
You don't think it's Bent's camp?
Well, more than likely it's them Indians we've been seeing. It looks like they're not very shy either, else this campfire would spread. We'll camp here. 3 days, damn it, no sign of a man that wants to be found.
There's no sign of Bent before we reach the river. We'll split up. Cover more ground.
I don't think we should split up.
Behind you.
George McGee, put him down. He's a friend of mine.
Man ready for war?
Why are you here? This place not safe for anybody. Bad people here.
We're looking for my son.
I have seen a boy. Very small boy. The man who drives a cart.
I'll be dead.
This man you saw, this is the man that stole my son. Where did you see him?
Glenn's post. It's one 2 days south on the Cimarron. I leave now. To scout this place. Travel south. When we meet, I will take you there. Then I owe you nothing.
Have
your tickets to Charleston here in 3 days and three nights along the way.
Good. Oh, if you think our house in Chicago is something, wait till you see Mount Royal. It's so beautiful. It's got silk curtains and Persian carpets and beautiful mahogany banisters. It's such a house. If you only knew how I've dreamt about belonging, having it belong to me.
Right. Just mind your manners.
But of course.
These will be the new docks. Behind them, the warehouses. Finest seaport addition in the entire South.
Yes, yes, proximity between the docks and the warehouses.
Why, brother dear. And Mr. Keyes, lovely to see you again.
Miss Maine, my pleasure.
It's Mrs. Fenway now. A Fenway pianist.
I'm not fully surprised to see you, Ashton. I'm not entirely pleased either. And married as well? Where is Mr. Fenway?
Busy making money in Chicago.
You excuse us, Keyes?
Yes, I wouldn't want to intrude on a family reunion. Splendid scheme, Cooper. We'll talk later.
You interrupted my business.
Why, Cooper? Is that any way to greet your sister?
This is no social call, knowing you.
No. First things first, and first to me is I want to purchase Mount Royal.
That would be a substantial purchase.
Yes, and we have more than substantial funds, thanks to Fenn's genius and my industry. We are rich.
There is another complication, and that is that our dear sister-in-law Madeline is ensconced in Mount Royal, and thanks to her industry she's making the payments promptly.
Oh, or it was a fool to marry that jumped up negress. But that might just work for us after all. Then we'll transfer funds from our Chicago bank over to your bank here in Charleston, and I'll use bribery money to get orders for her immediate eviction.
That might not be necessary.
Well, it may not be necessary, but it will be a pleasure.
Charlie, there's something I gotta tell you. One night back at the Point, more than 20 years ago, Ori and I sneaked out to Benny Havens for some mail. Remember that place? Ben followed us. He was always trying to catch us out. It's the middle of winter. He sat in his blizzard for a couple hours so he could put us on report. Well, we dodged him. We ran across the river on the ice. But Ben fell through. We stood there, heard his cries for help. We almost didn't go back, but we did. We saved his life.
You saved the wrong person, but you did the right thing.
Alive. A Cheyenne woman tends them. The man watches everything.
Is anybody with him?
Maybe. Inside. I do not know. Nia, see me. I go with you.
No, you fought enough.
Have not you?
Yes, but you're alone, aren't you?
Yes.
Besides, if you die, who's going to teach the young? this isn't your war either.
You think I'm gonna miss out now? You crazy that son of a bitch we've been chasing across this godforsaken country. Besides, you don't want to scare the boy. You better shave.
Get over here, boy. Come here. Go fetch the boy some food in the kitchen.
How'd it do, sir?
How'd it do yourself? Where you from, boy?
Well, I'm from up east, sir, around about Washington, where you see. And I wanted to just see the works. Everybody keep talking about the west up there.
What you want here, Drag?
Well, just a place to rest these tired bones.
How long you been riding? Your horse is fresh for me.
Well, sir, you know I haven't been on my horse all little trout. You know, every now and then I get off the horse, walk a little bit, trying to get me a little water. He's about as much rest as I have, you understand what I'm saying, don't you, sir?
You a buffalo hunter?
Fixing to be.
Well, you ain't gonna find no buffalo around here.
No, I ain't. Well, if you don't mind.
You want a bed down in the yard, that'll be $1 a night. You want water, that's 50 cents a bucket. You want to water your horse, that's 50 cents more.
Well, that's some steep price, ain't it?
Well, you can take it, or you can leave it.
What do you say, friend?
Specs, I'll take it.
Now, if you don't mind, let me get on down by the saddle, yeah? You can ride as long as I have.
What you looking at? You got a problem with the boy here?
That's none of my concern. But that's some handsome woman.
She's for sale. $3 a whack.
Well, thank you. But no, see, I met this chick he wanted about 3 days back. No, but she done enough to last a man a whole year.
I'm not interested in hearing that kind of talk from you, boy. Now, you give me a dollar and pick yourself out a soft piece of ground.
Devil or nothing for the ground?
You think I'm some kind of fool, boy?
No, sir. Never.
Now, you pick yourself a spot, or you be on your way.
You're a little too smart for your own good, ain't you? I don't think I like you, Ray.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, sir. When I think about it, I think I like you quite a bit.
Get out of here. Get on your horse.
Yes, boss.
Papa!
Jesse!
Hello, Ben.
Basil, you come for your wife's earring?
You bastard. I take no pleasure in killing, but I'll make an exception in your case.
Come on, don't! Don't! Come on! Save some for Charlie!
You never did respect me, neither you. But I was born to lead great armies like Hannibal, Alexander, Napoleon. And you and your inferior tribes kept me from my rightful place in history with your false accusations of desertion, abuse. You slandered my good name. But you paid for it, didn't you?
Do it.
Military genius is a rare gift.
Yeah!
You're killing Bonaparte!
Each man take 5 sticks of dynamite home with him. And the night of the attack, we all meet back at Getty's store, an hour after sundown.
We hit the school or the Negro shacks.
All of it, including the house. And Cooper, it's up to you to take care of your high yellow sister-in-law, Miss Madeline.
What do you mean, take care of?
Scrag her, boy.
I never killed anyone in my life.
Well, now's the time. Unless you want her in your life forever.
She has a child, my nephew.
That little boy is part Negro, just like her. You want to claim him for yourself and raise him and pretend that he is a decent white man?
If he has an ounce of Negro blood in his body, he can't never claim to be human, Cooper.
No.
Were you with the brethren or not?
Come on, Cooper. Now's the time for deciding.
Yeah, what's it gonna be?
You with us or against us?
I'm with you.
And you will do what you are called on to do?
Yes.
That's right.
That's right, Tucker.
You can't do this. You can't harm Madeline and the baby.
You spying on me?
That wasn't my intention. I just saw the horses and I was curious.
You heard everything?
I heard more than enough. Don't let these animals drag you down.
Stay out of my affairs.
But you are planning murder.
Madeline will always be a thorn in my side.
But she is family.
She's a negress. We have none of those in my family, dear.
I cannot allow you to do this.
You can't allow. You're a woman. You don't tell me what I can and will not allow. You. Your duty is to me, woman. You don't tell me anything. You just support me in what I do.
Why don't you go on inside and tend your house? And see there's a meal. Woman.
Cooper, they mean to wipe you out.
Judith, they've tried before.
This time they mean it. They mean to destroy everything. They mean to kill you. Well, I don't know, Sue. I have to get back there before Cooper begins to wonder.
Thank you for the warning, Judith.
You take care now, Madeline. Yeah.
Gentlemen, I'm sorry. I'm going to have to leave. Madeline expects an attack from the brethren.
The clan? When?
Anytime. Could be now. Excuse me.
It'll be tight, but I've arranged to go straight through by private car, with orders to be switched all along the line. With any luck, I'll be in Charleston by tomorrow night.
I guess being a general still carries some clout.
I guess it does.
Well, this was supposed to be goodbye seeing you off, but it looks like we're all going our separate ways now.
Seems so, Captain.
It's not Captain for a long time.
Well, you'll always be that to me. These are for you.
Thank you, Magic.
You're welcome. Well, don't miss your train, Magic.
Good luck, Magic.
Excuse me, George. I'm going with you.
Like hell you are. It's time Gus got to know his father.
Look, Gus wouldn't even be here if it weren't for your help. Damn it, Mountain Laurel's my home, too. I'm going along.
All right. Best hurry with your goodbye. The train's about to leave.
Gussie, I gotta go away again. But I'll be back very soon. And you're gonna stay at the Duncan's with Willa. You understand me, son?
Yes, I do, Dad.
Willa, I gotta go. I'll be back, I promise.
When? Next week? Next month? Next year?
I keep my word, Willa.
How can you ask me to wait again? You ask for too much, Charlie. If you go, don't expect to find me here when you come back. If you come back.
Time to go, Charlie.
General, Willa, let's go.
I gotta go. I gotta.
Boy, you're one romantic cuss, aren't you?
I can't do this, George.
My, just look at you, Madeline, dear, laboring like the common Negro that you are.
How dare you show your face on my property after murdering my husband?
Well, I didn't do that. Bent killed him. All I wanted was all his money.
Get off my property!
It's not your property anymore. I just purchased the mortgage from Cooper. And you see this paper here? This is an official eviction notice that I brought with me from Charleston. So Mount Royal is now mine, and as of this moment, I'm moving in and you are out.
Ashton, please!
Oh, what the...
Don't you ever show your face around here!
Ashton, that's enough. Sorry for the inconvenience, Mrs. Spade.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm altering your plans.
What are you talking about?
You don't know, Mount Royal. I never put the money in Cooper Main's bank.
You do it immediately. I mean, please, you're my husband. Oh, please do it.
Not yet, I'm not. I warned you. You didn't learn. Now, maybe you will.
Oh, my beautiful Mount Royal. What in God's name's happened to you?
Come on, dear. Come on. It's all right.
you anyway.
Said this is going to be our line of defense. Let's take the sack over there, Burns.
That's good. Now let's get some of those grain sacks in front of the wheels. Parker, right up in here with those barrels.
Move the wagons back to back. We need to set up a flank position.
What now? Ever shoot a rifle? Lord, no. Time to learn.
Let me see your weapon.
Good.
Never seen weapons this old since I was a boy. But they're in good working order.
Madeline.
Can I have a rifle?
No.
I know how to shoot. Isaac taught me. And I got a debt to settle.
I know. But I need you to take Ori and hide. I have no one else. All right. But I'd feel better if I were here. Thank you. I love you.
Be there in 2 more hours. You better pray we're in time.
Y'all know what a volley means? That means you don't go shooting on your own. You wait till the word's given, then we all fires together.
I don't rightly know about this, Michael. We don't know nothing about fighting.
We knows about living. That'd be good enough.
What if they don't come?
They'll come. Once they make a plan, they'll stick to it. These are sad, slow-witted men. All except Cooper. He's the wild card in all this. That makes him the most dangerous.
And I'll aim for him first.
Please, don't.
Why not?
He's still my family.
He's no blood kin to you.
He is to my son. Are you all right?
What do you think?
I think we're fighting for what we believe in. Take a look around. Reload and pray.
Mm-hmm.
Still a piece to Mount Royal, huh?
Tracks are still torn up from here to Charleston.
Yeah, well, if you yanks hadn't destroyed the rail lines, it wouldn't be so, would it?
You want to stay here and debate the war all night, or do you want to ride?
That's right. Come on. Yeah!
Ready, man?
We ready.
Fire on my order. Cock your weapons.
Stay here! Don't fire! Whoa! Don't fire!
you won't be needing me, I'll be getting back now.
To Willa, I trust?
Three of us. It's gonna work out.
This is your home, Charlie. All three of you are welcome here. All the time.
Thank you, Charlie. Do you still want to rebuild?
I don't know. It meant so much to me once. But now, what for?
For yourself.
For our children. And for us.
Us.
I am never going to leave you again, Madeline.
Oh, George.
But if we build for us, we build anew. Agreed?
Agreed. Remember, we're partners, Mr. Hazard. Forever.